America's COVID recovery has hit a dangerous roadblock. Infections are spiking across the country. Hospitalizations and deaths are also rising.
Nationwide, COVID hospitalizations almost doubled in the last week. The vast majority of those patients are unvaccinated. Virus hotspots, including Florida and Hawaii, are facing record-breaking infection levels.
2 days after protesting against masks in Florida, more than 21,000 people tested positive for COVID-19. It's a single-day record for the Sunshine State, and on the same day, the governor said this.
There will be no restrictions and no mandates in the state of Florida.
Republican Ron DeSantis is tipped by many to run for president in 2024. He says despite Florida's fresh wave, there will be no mask mandates and no school closures.
Floridians have been, are, and will remain free to choose what's best for themselves and their family.
And that choice in Florida even extends to how kids and their families approach school. Governor DeSantis says he will cut the funding of any school that requires students to wear masks.
We have a statement from Governor Ron DeSantis' office explaining that after he had already threatened to withhold funding from school districts that have mask mandates, now he's threatening to withhold the salaries of superintendents and school board members, school officials in these districts where masks are required.
3 weeks ago, Governor Ron DeSantis threatened to withhold salaries of school officials, defying his ban on mask mandates. It appears he's now making good on that promise.
Governor Ron DeSantis is remaining firm with his ban on mask mandates in Florida schools, despite an uptick in cases among children.
From Politico, Florida defies judge and punishes two school districts over masks. The Florida Department of Education is now withholding salaries from school board members in Alachua and Broward counties, the first two to pass mask mandates in defiance of DeSantis's order. This comes after Judge John Cooper ruled Friday that the governor's blanket ban on mask mandates is unconstitutional, a crushing blow to DeSantis, but a win for literally everyone else.
An executive order and or an agency action which bans under all circumstances a face mask mandate for school children without a parental opt-out does not meet constitutional muster.
While giving his ruling, Cooper likened the mask situation to laws against drunk driving.
It's our right to drink alcoholic beverages if we're over 21, but we cannot get in our car and start driving around while we've had alcoholic beverages that impair our ability to drive. The reason is the driver exercising his or her rights to drink is now putting at risk other people.
The last time we checked, conservatives wanted to give more authority and freedom to local schools to set their own protocols, not have those schools beholden to state or federal politicians. But now, if a Florida community has a COVID-19 outbreak and the local schools want to try and take extra steps to protect the kids, forget about it. Governor DeSantis gets to decide. Mark my words, this is going to cause needless hospitalizations of children in Florida, and it's going to haunt DeSantis politically.